How many unread emails do you have in your inbox right now? 100? A few hundred? 1,000 or more? If so, don't worry. This is normal. But it doesn't have to stay that way. Studies show that the average worker spends 8 to 11 hours per week replying and sorting through their email inbox. This is the equivalent of showing up to work every day and watching the new Top Gun movie before you get anything else done. But imagine if your productivity could be increased by an hour or 2 or even 3 hours per week by managing your inbox more efficiently. I've done that through my recent journey to achieve inbox zero at least weekly, and if not, every other day. One of the things I was doing wrong is I was using my email inbox as a task list. This is a bad way to manage tasks because when I go to my inbox to look for my next task, I'm distracted by the new email that's coming in, the new product that AppSumo has for sale, and that before I know it, I'm on AppSumo's website buying something I probably don't need because I was distracted by my email. So as part of the process of learning not to use my inbox for tasks, I have automated the creation of tasks on Monday from my email, and I'm going to show you how to do that in this video. But first, my name is Andy O'Neill, and I help entrepreneurs like you add time-saving automation to their business. Check out the description to get one-on-one help with Make and to sign up for my weekly email newsletter. And as always, please hit the like button and consider subscribing if you like this video and it's of value to you and you want to get more of my videos in the future. Let's start with looking at a copy of my task list board in Monday. You can see we've got an item, and this item is going to be the subject line that comes across in our emails that are actually tasks. I automatically assign myself. If someone else needs to be assigned, I can change that. I automatically give it a status of received, and then when I come in here and look at this, I will give it a priority, either high, medium, or low. Next is the sender's name. Next is when the email was sent, and here is a link to the email thread and the Gmail thread ID. The Gmail thread ID is important because as we get new emails in for this same task in the same email thread, those are going to be added to this Monday board as updates. Okay, we're over here in Make, and I've created a new scenario, and we're going to use this to build out the creation of tasks from email to Monday. I want to give this a name. First thing I want to do is add a Gmail. So I'm going to type Gmail here. Select Gmail, and we're going to watch emails. So what this is going to do, it's going to watch new emails coming into my inbox. All right, so right up here, if you're new to Make, this is your connection. And if you're using Make for the first time or you're using Gmail inside of Make for the first time, you're going to need to click Add and authenticate your Gmail account with Make. All right, right here, we're going to go to Folder. We're going to go to All Mail. And then we're going to do a Gmail filter. And we're going to create a label, a search for a label. Now I have a label in my inbox that I created, which is underscore create Monday task. And what that does is when I drag an email into that label, this module will look for mail and it will find anything with that label on it. So here's an example of an email from AppSumo. I just click right here and I would drag that down to the create Monday task label. And then that would get pulled into my Monday board. So I run this scenario about every 15 minutes because I want to keep my inbox up to date. So I'm going to put 100 emails here. I'm sure I don't get 100 emails per 15 minutes, but I just want to make this number large enough so we get all of the emails that have come in since the last time this scenario ran. For now, I'm going to select the first email and I'm going to select that AppSumo email and hit OK. And then I'm going to run this just to get some data. So I should get some data right there. Good. All right. Next, we're going to put in a Monday module, type search. And we're going to search for items by column value. Same thing as before. If you've not used monday.com with Make in the past, you just click add and you're going to authenticate that Monday account with Make. So I'm going to look here. What I'm looking for is in my board, I have this Gmail thread. So what happens is if any new emails come in that are a part of the thread for this task, I'm actually looking for those emails and adding them as updates in Monday. So all of my email thread is in Monday as updates. So that's what this search is doing. So I'm going to search for one And I'm going to select my board ID, tasks from email. That's what I've got over here. And then the column I want to search is this Gmail thread column. So I'm going to look down here. I'm going to find Gmail thread ID and the column value. And I'm going to look over here. There's our thread ID. So I'm going to look and see if there is an item that already exists that has the thread ID of this email. If it doesn't, we're going to create a new task and an update with this email. If it does have one, we're just going to add an update and add this information from this email to that task. Now we're going to put a router in. I'm going to go down here and put a router right here. And I'm going to click here in the middle and we will get two paths that are created. This one, we're going to say the ID of our search does not exist. All right. That means Monday looked for the thread and it didn't return a value. So there's no ID associated with that. So we're going to create our task and our update on our Monday board. So I'm going to put create task update. Right here, we're going to create our task. Create an item. You would pick your connection up here. So my item name is going to be the subject. There's our subject. So I've selected my board from the list. The group ID, I want to put current tasks. That's what I have over here for current. And then I have completed. I also have an automation on this board that when this status goes to done, it moves automatically down to the completed section, just like that. So I'm going to put it in current tasks, and then I'm going to give it the items I need to map, which include the Gmail thread, the link to the email thread. Okay, so let me talk about this link real quick. The link to emails, they have the ID of the user in them. And if you're like me, if you sign in to multiple Gmail accounts or Google Workspace accounts, you will have each account will have a different user in that URL. And if you were to ever log into your accounts in a different order, that user number that we're pulling from this email could change. So what I found is if I remove that user, it still has the ID and Gmail is smart enough to know what user that is associated with, and it will add the user ID back. So when we're putting this in here, I'm saying take the message link and use this little bit of regular expression and replace it with an empty string. So basically we're removing that user ID and saving it that way. But if you ever click on it later and you're logged in a different order, it will associate that email with the right account and it will add that user ID back. So I'm not going to map the person. I have that on the board. When an item is created, it's automatically connected to me. For priority, I'm not going to map that either because I'm going to set that when I go look at the task. For sender's name, this is text, and I'm going to go over here to the sender name. And next we're going to do sent, and you can do a now value when this is created, but I'm actually going to use the date of the email in case there's a lag here. So I'm going to go right over here to the date, and that is a date formatted. You can see in that pop-up, so I don't need to do any formatting on that date. And we are all done here. Hit OK. So now if it cannot find that thread, it's going to create a task. Now we want to create an update. So we're going to go to Monday. We're going to type update, create an update. We're going to make sure our account is the same. The item ID, we're going to map from this previous one because we want this to be connected to this ID. And then the body, I'm going to go down here, and a lot of these emails get really messy with HTML. So I'm just going to add the text version in here. Okay, so here's the text, and I'm going to do a strip HTML because sometimes there's some HTML still in there. We're just going to strip that out and hit OK. So if we have a new message, let's give these some names. So I'm going to say that one is watch labeled emails. We're searching an existing item here. We're creating a task item here, and we're creating an update on that task right here. All right, so our top part of our router is for a new task. And just a note, the routers always go left to right and top to bottom. So this is going to check here first to create if it needs to create a new one. If not, it's going to run this part second. So we're going to say over here, the ID exists. So we're going to create update on existing. All right, so we hit OK there, and now we're going to create an update. I'm actually going to copy this update right here and clone it and drag it here and then delete this one. I'm going to have to fix this module because this one is referencing this one here it's created. But down here, we're adding an update to an existing one. So I'm going to map the ID to this module right here. Okay, so let's save that. All right, now it's time to run a test. So I'm going to go right over here and I'm going to say choose where to start. I'm going to say select first email. And I'm going to pick that AppSumo email and hit OK. And then let's run this. All right, so you can see we haven't run this with the AppSumo. So it looked here and it did not find an existing item. So it went this route. And let's go look at our tasks. All right, right here is order confirmation. Here is our note, our update added here. Okay. So that's all of our information from that email. We stripped out the HTML, and so we're going to have some nice clean links here. So I want to add something to these update creation. I want a little more information at the top of this. So what I've done is I've added some additional information. Sometimes with these threads, the people that reply aren't the people who sent it the first time. So I'm actually putting the sender's name in here. Move this over here. And the sender's email. And then I'm creating a link back to this particular reply from Gmail. So let me add this over here to this update as well. And I'm going to open up this and just pause for a second so you can copy this into your update if you want to use that. All right, so let's go here and let's hit OK and let's run this one again and see what that looks like. Choose where to start, select the first email, AppSumo, hit OK. Now this time it should find that thread and add an update right here. And it did. So we're going to go right over here. Now we have two updates and I'm going to click on that and let's look at the top one. All right, so we got from AppSumo. This is the information we added up here at the top. And here is the view Gmail message. And if I click on that, I go right to that email in my inbox. Just a note about these view Gmail messages we're creating, where we're taking out the user ID. For me, at least on my Android with Gmail app, they do not work. If I click on them, they try to open the web version, but they don't go to that message. This only works for me on my desktop or laptop computer where I've got the full web-based Gmail app running. Let me show you how to schedule our automation. By default, it's going to run every 15 minutes, and that is fine. So we're going to save this, exit out of it, and go right up here and turn it on. And our scenario will probably start running. You can see right here, it did run immediately. It didn't find any new mail because we just checked it. And so now your scenario is set up to run every 15 minutes and to find new items in your Google Workspace email and turn those into Monday tasks. If you need one-on-one help with Make, or you want to subscribe to my email newsletter that I send out weekly on Tuesdays, check out the description. And I thank you for watching, and I'll see you next time.